Now, one thing, I ain't gonna lie, we had a lot of people sit on this couch, but one thing that they don't come with, unfortunately, is a lot of culture behind them. Not only musically, your culture.
You niggas from Idaho.
Yeah. The only music. Right.
This was a black man.
Man, I'm telling you, man. Yeah. You got culture too. You know, I want to go through that, man, because, again, you know, you have a status. Touch on your status in the motherland, and tell us how did you obtain it. What's required? Getting that chieftain.
Abia State, man.
Abia State, yes.
Big chief shit, man. Ofemi Umaya, you know what I'm saying? You know, I did this record with Wande Cole. So it was my first time in Nigeria, you know what I'm saying? And boy, you get off that plane in that international airport, nigga, and you know, immediately it's different, nigga. Like it's a culture shock.
Explain what you mean by culture shock.
Man, you know, like, yeah, that shit don't look like nothing you gonna ever see in America. That shit ain't gonna, like, when I stopped it. But my nigga, I'm trying to tell you it was lit. I'm trying to tell you, like, so we stopped in Ethiopia, and first we went to Canada. I partied in the six with them niggas, with a whole bunch of Nigerians. Then we went to Ethiopia, Addis Ababa, fucking with that Dodo Watt, you know what I'm saying? But when I got off the plane, nigga, you get off the plane like on the ground, like outside on the ground, nigga, no pavement, like where the plane take off at, nigga. Like, so nigga, I got off the plane on the ground, big ass, like field and shit, nigga. I'm saying like, nigga, Mufasa, that nigga is nigh. Like, nigga, I thought I was going to get eight, you know what I'm saying? So we sat out there in the hot, the smeltering heat, nigga, for like
they created a word for the heat.
Man, like there was no organization to that shit. Like you had to find out like where you was.
Oh, you was on Soul Plane, nigga.
It was an experience. And then when I got to when I got to Nigeria, but man, on the plane, I just gotta back up. My nigga, it was like, nigga, flying international, my nigga, like make you never want to fly domestic again. Like, nigga, it was so big, nigga, up in there, nigga. You could drink as much as you want to. You buy Gucci, nigga, Versace, nigga, Black Label, nigga. Like, we was fucked up. We was fucked up by the time I landed, nigga, I was gone. Like, and so the nigga next to me, I don't know how long I got, but because I could go for a long time. The nigga's like next to me is like, how much money do you got? And I'm like, nigga, what? Nigga,
like, he has his own money.
You hear the nigga? I'm the chief.
Nigga, so I was the chief at this time. The chief at this time, okay. Nigga. So I was like, nigga, what's
your? Wait. You went on a trip and came back a chief?
Yeah, like that. Yeah.
What the fuck?
Yeah.
Sorry.
Like that.
You robbed, nigga. This nigga the plug, man.
So the nigga was like, how much money you got, nigga? And I was like, nigga, what you mean? And then the nigga pulled out. Nigga, big ass wad. Nigga, he had Canadian money. The nigga had, nigga, money from Dubai. Nigga, money from Nigeria. Money from America. Nigga, he's like, nigga, I don't want your money. So I pulled out. Nigga, I had like a few bands on me. He was like, don't show nobody. And I'm like, what do you mean? He's like, don't show nobody. When I went in there, nigga, it was like the customs was, man, it was crazy, my nigga. They was trying to detain me. We don't do none of that shit now. Now my niggas come straight to the plane and get a nigga straight off. Like, you know what I'm saying? My manager over there, they work for Foreign Affairs, so we don't even have to go through none of that shit. So I went over there, I did the record with Wande Cole, and I was just hurting.
But how did you get the feature with Wande Cole in the first place? Like, how did y'all link up?
Well, it's not like in America, my nigga. Everybody knows somebody. You know what I'm saying? So when them niggas seen, like, niggas was coming through there, like, nigga, they could smell the money on you. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. They was like, nigga, you need to do the record with this nigga, or you need to do the record with this nigga, or Burna Boy, or T.Y. Savage. And so I was like, well, nigga, I ain't even never heard this music. Nigga, let me listen to it. You know what I'm saying?
So you mean to tell me you can get a feature from, like, the Wizkid and niggas like that?
Yeah. Damn. I was at Wizkid's house. That nigga got his face.
That's like getting a song. Yeah. That's like getting a feature with Drake, nigga.
Yeah,
what the fuck?
Yeah.
I ain't need a one dance.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah. Tennessee in my
hands. Yeah.
Man, come on, man.
That nigga.
Yeah. I'm like, and we're talking about Dallas?
He went over there and secured the feature, nigga, from Wande Cole. Yeah. Keep going. This is interesting.
Wizkid from Sudo Larry, nigga, and okay. I was at that nigga's house. His face was all in the ground and marble and shit, nigga. That's big shit. You know what I'm saying? It's crazy. Yeah, it's crazy. Yeah, Bentley's all out there and shit. I don't even know how they got out there. But so anyway, so shit, man, I was just the way I became high chief really was I just was seeing a whole bunch of, like, for lack of a better word, like a whole bunch of fuck shit happening. Like, and I, like I said, I grew up in the ghetto in California. So like, I couldn't really like watch niggas not be eating, like really not eating. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like we got ghettos out here, but them niggas got slums, cousin. Yeah, like nigga, I'll be driving past the slums on the way to where I'm going, like nigga, shed a tear type shit. Like nigga, you know, nigga, like asbestos, nigga, motherfucking gangrene, like niggas are sleeping in there. You know what I'm saying? So nigga, I just was like, I would keep seeing these girls, badass girls too, my nigga, like the girls in Africa, my nigga, I'm talking about they just bad, like originally bad.
Yeah.
They was walking up and down. They was walking up and down the street, my nigga, like with the little things on their head, like, you know what I'm saying? Like in the books when we growing up in school and shit. And so I asked my manager, like at the time he wasn't my manager, I was like, where the fuck are they going? Why they keep leaving and coming back and leaving and coming back? He's like, they're going to fetch water. I was like, nigga, what do you mean, like going to fetch water? What does that mean? He's like, nigga, they ain't got no water in their whole community. So they gotta walk like 4 or 5. I was like, nigga, are you serious? How much does it cost for a nigga to get water? And they told me whatever the equivalent was in Naira. I was like, but nigga, how much is that in American money? It was $500. I was like, let's go over there. And so I went over there and I put water in that whole community. And so
Damn, for $500?
So they call it a borehole. You know what I'm saying? I put a borehole over there, my nigga. Like,
hold on, wait. I gotta ask you a question now, because my dad, he's stuck in Nigeria, right?
Yeah.
And we get this nigga like $400 a month. Is he finessing me?
He's up. He definitely. Yeah,
man, I'm gonna talk to this nigga, man. He's
up. Hey, but that's your bad though. Hey, he's definitely. Hey, he's definitely.
Nigga every week.
You giving him $400 a week?
No, not a month.
Oh yeah, he's up. Yeah,
oh, this
you know
nigga
what I'm
acting
saying?
Like he doing bad. I'm nah, like, are you sure?
Nah, he's up because they only make like at a regular job, like they only make like $30 a month.
I'm finna hit this nigga with the conversion rate, man. Hold on, daddy. You got about 100,000 naira, my nigga.
Yeah,
send me a camel or something, nigga. A tiger. Fuck you mean?
A camel, a tiger, I'm dead. So that's how it happened, man. They just heard the king kept hearing about everything that I was doing. So like, you know what I'm saying? I'm out there in the strip club fucking off the money. You know what I'm saying? We doing it all. You know what I'm saying? And so like, shit, I just sent like 20 kids to college. You know what I'm saying? Damn. It wasn't no money, my nigga. It was like just a few bands. Just to do that, you know what I'm saying? So I sent like, I don't know, like another 15 school kids, because like they don't have public school, you know what I'm saying? You gotta pay for that. You right. Don't pay for it, your kid don't go. You know what I'm saying? So I paid for the kids' transport for a month and paid for all their school for the year type shit, you know?
Respectfully though, if they have a Wande Cole, a WizKid, and other big artists out there, are they not doing the same? Like for $500 you did that?
I can speak about all of Africa, but like Nigeria is definitely tribal. So, you know, I'm pretty sure they do for their tribe. You know what I'm saying? But if you're not connected to them, they can't just take care of everybody. You know what I'm saying? But I'm pretty sure they do for their own.
Have you wanted to?
That's cultural.
Have you wanted to take like 3 racks and just build like a 5-story mansion or something?
Oh, over there?
Yeah. Like
I got one.
I'm slow. I'm behind the times. See, I knew
you. You spend 13 bands over there, nigga. You gonna have like a $3 million house over here. It's all gonna be real. Ain't gonna be no siding. It ain't gonna be no drywall, nigga. That's gonna be straight wood, nigga. Straight marble, nigga. Like yeah.
For everyone like with the PPP, the stimulus, and they tell you to go back to Africa. Nigga, yeah. Go.
Yeah.
Build you a future.
And the thing about it is that they love you.
And they love you.
They love you. They love the dysphoria. They love, that was a big reason why. So I know we didn't really touch on why I even wanted to go to Africa in the first place. My mom and my dad died. I wasn't close to my mom at all. And I wasn't close to my dad at all, you know, but when they died, it kind of made a nigga feel lost. You know what I'm saying? Like, I just felt like I didn't know like nothing. You know what I'm saying? Like my mom is dead. I'm calling on the phone, like trying to ask her shit about my family and she dead. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So I was like, fuck it. I have a daughter, you know what I'm saying? I was like, I need to be able to tell her where she's from. As black people in America, they tell you from Africa, but you never know where. You know what I mean?
That's right.
So I did an ancestry test, you know, to find out where my family was from in America. Where does the Guyton name come from, which is my mom's side? Where does the Brodus name come from, which is my dad's side?
Brodus?
Yeah, like Calvin Brodus, Snoop, you know what I'm saying? That's my dad. Yeah, that's my dad's side of the family.
Calvin Brodus?
Yeah, so, and then, you know, the DNA test, nigga, gonna break it all down, everything, like every drop of blood. So it told me I was from Nigeria, nigga, so I pulled up.
That's some real shit.
Yeah, and it was crazy, dog. Like, standing on that land, nigga, where your ancestors is from, my nigga, like, I was, like that was a surreal ass moment. Like, standing there with the ships and the boats and the cages they was putting on niggas' faces, and, you know what I'm saying? They still got all that shit in Baghdad, right? You know what I'm saying?
They, serious.
Yeah.
It almost sounds like, from your experience, everybody from America, black, should go take a trip out there to see how it is.
You should definitely find out where you're from out there,
right?
And then you should go there.
What are some of the misconceptions that you think people have? Right. Like, you know, when you went out there, what was something you thought?
I thought I was going to see the little kids with the ribs showing and the flies all in their eyes and the lions and the hyenas. So I have to probably come back and do another interview. But when I got there, my nigga, I was asking niggas like, hey, bro, so which side of the street is the lions on? Like, nigga. What block do the hyenas be at so I don't be there? Niggas is looking at me like, lions, hyenas, nigga. You know what I'm saying? So, like, one, America, you know what's crazy, though, my nigga? Looking at America from another country, looking at all the people looking back at America, you will never really see America until you're out of America. That's when I knew, like, wait a second, I'm moving the wrong way there. Like, I'm not maximizing the way I need to maximize. When I was watching the world news in Africa, looking back at America, that shit was life-changing.
Do you think Black Panther and that Wakanda, like, bettered the look of, let's say, Africa, or made
damn,
it more?
Damn, bro, why you doing this, G?
Come on.
I'm trying to stay away from certain shit, like, because my niggas is, like, executive producer on Black Panther, you know what I'm saying?
So,
like,
my partner made
you know
the
what
movie.
I'm saying? All I can say is that, nigga, wasn't no African artists on that motherfucker, you know what I'm saying? So, think about it. Put two and two together.
Put two and two together.
You know, that's, you know.
So, now that you did get the chieftain role, and, of course, what you did as far as your philanthropy out there, yeah. What are you using that for now, as far as going forward or at least going on now? How are you using that in your favor and into either Nigeria's favor or even Africa's favor?
I'm just really, you know, I'm just really trying to be, now that I have been blessed, you know what I'm saying, to be at a certain place financially in America, I'm trying to just extend that even past the hood. You know what I'm saying? Niggas always want to go back to the block, nigga. I want to go back where it started. You know what I'm saying? Like, you can heal a kid that's unhealthy, putting back in that unhealthy environment, he gets sick again. You know what I'm saying? I want to correct all the misconceptions up until from the beginning up until this point. Niggas think they gangsters because they don't know that they was kings. You know what I'm saying? When I became high chief, nigga, the Eze, the king, gave me my own land. Like, off the rip. Like, this is my son. Gave me my own land so I could build a house. What I need credit for, nigga, when I can build a mansion, what the fuck is we even talking about?
He has his own money.
Hey, so, well, do you see a scenario in which you're just gonna go over there for good?
For a fact, I probably got 5 years left in America.
That's what's up.
On God.
That's what's up.
Yeah, I'm all about motivation, bro. If I walk in and I see your face in marble, I'm motivated.
I'll be honest with you. Sounds like we, as Americans, are really bullshitting as far as helping art, the motherland. You said it only took $500 to knock that out. Like, who is the liaison between, you know, America and Africa to make these type of things happen? Who, you know, who does the
organization? I would love to get everybody in their fields and tell everybody to do it. But the fact of the matter is that the government's not where it really needs to be. Right. So you'll probably get scammed, because I got scammed for like millions before I even, you know what I'm saying, before I actually was able to contribute the right way. So it's just like, meet good people, meet authentic people. Big Igbo shit, you know what I'm saying?
Big Igbo shit.
Fuck with that Igbo shit, my nigga, and your money be straight.
Oh, my.
That's the businessman tribe, by the way.
That's real, there you go.
Shout out Real Street Stars, nigga. Moving. Hey.